Watchdog contra Daya.
Let us know what you think. Send us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag Primetime or post them on our Facebook page. That's ANC247. Rick, good evening to you and thanks for joining us tonight.
Good evening. Good evening.
Thank you for coming over. You were there during the mock polls over the weekend. Your initial impressions were?
Actually, the general impression is that the COMELEC is not ready to have this automated election again. All the errors that we have experienced in the 2010 elections, everything is on the mock polls.
Let's go over the errors one by one. The RG Cruz was already mentioning some of the ballots could not be fed into the machines. Yeah. There were transmission problems to the servers.
Yes.
All right. So these problems were experienced in the 2010 election. Right. Why do you think that these problems occurred again?
COMELEC has about 3 years to fix it since the 2010, but apparently they haven't done anything to fix all those errors. So we have, it was fortunate for them that they have a backup machine during the mock election, but you will not have backup machines in all precincts on the 2013 elections. So that would be very problematic because the first PICOS machine used on the mock elections, it did not accept any ballot, so they have to replace it.
Okay. Now, the ballot itself is being printed by the National Printing Office. Yep. They were using machines that were actually at least by the MPO. Why do you think there are errors in accepting the ballots in the machine? Shouldn't these all conform to the same standard that was used in 2010?
Yeah. What we have observed on the mock polls, actually, the ballots is like it's more delicate to feed it on the PICOS machine.
The material?
Yeah,
the
paper. Mm-hmm. On the 2010, when you feed the ballot, the PICOS machine would accept it as easily.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But on the mock poll, it's very difficult to feed it on the machine.
So you feel there's a difference in the material?
I don't know if they have used another ingredient for that paper, or they haven't have a right size for that PICOS machine, but it has been more difficult to feed
in the mock poll.
In the mock polls.
Mm-hmm. I wonder though, these problems you're saying should have been addressed by the COMELEC, but the machines are really owned by Smartmatic, right? So if there were any problems, it should have been the company itself, Smartmatic, that had to resolve these problems.
Yeah, the COMELEC should have sanctioned Smartmatic to fix everything during the 2010 election. Now that we have both the machine from Smartmatic for the 2013 election, it's our machines already. So it's a COMELEC responsibility now to fix everything on the machine.
But you know, in realistically speaking, COMELEC doesn't have the resources to fix the machines, right?
Yeah. So before the machines were both, the COMELEC should have asked Smartmatic to fix everything.
But
I think they haven't done that, and they have 3 years to do that, but they haven't.
Let's backtrack a bit. I think about 5-6 months ago, Tony, we were talking about this, the COMELEC was quite satisfied already. Mm. It was printed in all the broadsheets, and also it was in the news that they were quite satisfied already with how Smartmatic rectified some of these errors back in 2010.
Mm-hmm.
But apparently now you're saying.
Yeah.
They really didn't do anything.
Yeah. The problem with their pronouncement of those are simple glitches and the errors were all fixed is that they are all internal tests, meaning it's all COMELEC officers saying, observing those tests and then saying, okay, they're okay already.
Mm.
So when they put it into public eye, like for the mock polls, then everything is different. That actually the machines, the ballots, the procedures for the BEI, they are not ready to supposedly the mock poll should simulate what would happen on the actual day.
Mm.
But on that day, you would see COMELEC instructing BEI what to do on the machines, what are the procedures. So you would see that those things.
What do you mean? The coaching?
Yeah.
Mm. Which wouldn't normally happen on election day.
Yeah. Mm. Which will not happen on election day.
Now, when, as Contra Daya, you have a stake in making sure that the automated election system works at least 99.9% perfectly, but what can Contra Daya do to contribute to the improvement of the system before May?
Actually, we already have like other groups saying, like Senpeg, they have 30 problems and 30 fixes for the machines. And those fixes are already given to COMELEC. So it's up to them to look at those fixes and then fix those machines. Mm-hmm. So we in Contradaya, we want the election to be credible. I mean, we want every vote to be counted. Mm-hmm. We don't want ballots getting rejected and then people will not have another ballot.
Sure.
No? So we want everything to be fixed. Mm-hmm. The fixes are already there. The researches have been forwarded to them. But it's actually COMELEC to decide and actually act on those fixes.
When did you submit all those, the 30 errors and the 30 fixes?
The 30 errors and 30 fixes of CENPEG were already transmitted to them even before the 2010 elections. Because mm-hmm. we have other groups that were helping them to actually fix those machines.
And what do you think? Why are they not acting on these fixes?
It's hard to say what would they... it's a political will. I mean... it just have to, like, for the chairman to say, okay, let's fix everything, but apparently they're not doing.
You know, Smartmatic, as we all know, is a Venezuelan company, but the software that's used to run the PCOS machines
is actually owned by another company.
Owned by another company, which is Dominion. And only recently, just late last year, Dominion and Smartmatic were still engaged in a legal tussle as to whether or not the actual software for the machines had been given by Dominion. Is that right?
Smartmatic has a case against Dominion to allow it to use it for this election. Apparently, the license for the software is for only for the 2010 elections. So if we will be using the PCOS machine again in the 2013, and then COMELEC doesn't have a license for the 2013 usage of it, we are actually using it like a pirated software.
Uh-huh.
So SysTest, the other third-party testing company, mm-hmm. would not certify a software that is not licensed for COMELEC to use.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have an independent review on the source code. SysTest is commissioned by COMELEC. Mm-hmm. So of course it would be doubtful if it's really saying what is wrong, what are wrong on the source code.
Sure.
What we need is more than that third party commissioned by COMELEC, but what we need is other political parties with IT experts and to actually test and review the source code.
Because in the mock polls, what we're seeing are actually hardware problems, no? The inability of some machines to accept the ballots, the inability to transmit to the servers. But when you talk about a software issue here, you're talking about the integrity of the source code. And many people have already been talking about how the source code should have been checked before they were used on the PCOS machines. Now the issue here, as it has been revealed, is that Dominion may have given Smartmatic a copy of the source code that was not actually pre-tested.
Yes.
On the machines, is that right?
Yes, because Dominion will have a general software for any elections, and then it's up to Smartmatic to adapt it for every country that it's a provider.
Sure.
So for the COMELEC, for the Philippine election, actually we have one of the very difficult method of electing officers. You have votes from the precincts going to the municipalities, to the province, to the provincial canvassers, which do not happen in other countries.
Sure.
So it's more difficult to adapt the software. That's why it's more relevant to have a source code review of whatever software Smartmatic is using.
But what I'm actually curious about is whether, if the reports were telling us were accurate, that the source code that should have been installed in the PCOS machines for the May 10 elections was the same source code that they had pre-tested and given to Smartmatic. Because as the reports come out, it's not the same code. There are two codes, source codes. Is that right?
Yeah. So you have source code from Dominion and this actually used during the 2010 elections. So we actually don't know what version is in the central bank, deposited in the central bank.
Mm.
We don't have a way to check because COMELEC doesn't
open it to outside testing.
Actually, on the mock poll, there is one indicator that it could be a software problem. Hopefully, it's not. During the manual audit, in the UPIS, we have one or two votes more than the count of the PCOS machines is more than one or two votes than the manual audit.
Right. So, from what I read, there were issues of under voting and overvoting. Mm-hmm. So merong ballots na kulang yung nabilang na boto, meron naman ballots na sumobra yung bilang. Mm. So that is indicative of a software problem.
Right. Actually, undervote means the voter voted like for 12 senators, he or she voted for 11. Yeah. So okay. they are counting it just for recording purposes.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So but any votes for undervote or overvote, for undervote the vote will be counted, but for overvote the position you voted for will not be counted.
Mm.
So they have a recording of it, okay. But the problem during the manual audit, the votes of some candidates doesn't match.
So being an IT expert, how would you explain that?
I actually asked Sir James Jimenez, so what could be the possible. So he's saying it could be the ballot, meaning supposedly every grid on the ballot is divided into grids, mm-hmm. and then the machine reads every grid, mm-hmm. and then every grid is matched to a candidate. So if the alignment of the ballot, the grid is different, you'll be giving votes to another candidate. So that could be one. Or it could be the software is really counting different counts. Now we don't know. Unless COMELEC opens everything and say, hey, come on, and then let's test and see what's really the problem.
Okay. And you're saying open everything, you mean begin source with the source code?
And then allow third party political parties to actually test and run the codes, and then let's check. Mm. If it's reading and counting our ballots correctly.
And the issue against opening the source code to outside parties for verification, mm-hmm. how dangerous is it or how risky is it to do that?
The reason always is that somebody will copy the source code.
Mm-hmm.
But then you could always have legal paper saying it's a non-disclosure agreement, wherein we have this, we are giving you the source code to review it, mm-hmm. and then both parties should abide by it.
Mm-hmm.
It happens in most companies. I mean, I could give you a contract saying you make me a software, and then that's only to be used by me. So that's allowed. So COMELEC can do that for political parties, such that political parties can review the source code.
Can they review it in an environment mm-hmm. where the one in control is only the COMELEC, meaning that source code can't be taken out of the premises by the party?
Unfortunately, during the 2010 election, their method of reviewing the source code, you actually have to sit on the computer wherein the source code is installed, and then that's in the COMELEC premises. When you do source code review, it's not like that. So it's like editing a story. It's not like editing a story wherein any computer can be used, yeah. and then at your own time, even if you are pressured, you can edit a story, because mm-hmm. that's a story. In source code, that's a bit different because you have to check every functions, every parts, if it's working well. Not the way COMELEC did it for SysTest, wherein it submitted parts by part. Meaning per paragraph, they are submitting source code to SysTest.
Mm-hmm.
And the SysTest said, we cannot review this. We only review source code if you give us the entire thing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So actually, that's while they are allowing to review the source code, but the method that they are allowing it, it's mm-hmm. actually not the way to do it.
Mm-hmm. Now, is there time, Rick, do you think, between now and May to carry out any of the 30 corrections, the 30 fixes that were already submitted before?
They have to work double time, triple time to do it.
They're planning another mock elections next month, I think.
Then we'll see if they'll be able to fix whatever errors during the first mock elections. But without if they can fix that in a short time.
Yeah.
Actually, some of the features of the machine would already give you some safeguards. Like say for now the PICOS machine would receive any ballot that you put into you xerox the ballot, you copy the ballot, and then fill it into it. Actually, it will read those
really?
Ballots.
So it doesn't look for the security features anymore?
Yeah. If you would remember during the 2010 elections, COMELEC said to Smartmatic that disabled the feature wherein the PICOS machine checks a fake ballot. And then when they disabled it, they bought ultraviolet lamps,
mm-mm, mm-mm,
and
mm-mm.
which the teachers doesn't know how to use.
Yeah. to check the security features of the
machine,
papers. Yeah.
If you have the same paper, the same component of the paper, and then the same layout of the ballot, you'll actually be able to feed it to the PICUS machine.
So as they're configured, they still work the same way as in 2010.
Mm. Yeah.
No. So in between now and in the next mock elections, you're thinking there's no time to make any of the fixes.
They have to work hard, but they're running out of time to fix everything. And whatever happened during the 2010 election, it will happen again, and it could be a bit worse. Mm. Meaning, you have those machines stored for 3 years. They are on boxes. Mm. And then you're taking them out again during the May elections. Mm-hmm. Is there an assurance that every machine has been tested? Mm. I mean, it's a common thing that if you have a machine stored for quite some time, mm-hmm. You'll encounter problems.
So what is the lead time, you think? Say there are 80,000 PIVOS machines, right?
Yeah.
What is the lead time for them to test each and every machine, make sure they're functioning in each polling precinct?
I can say that, but they should start testing it now. Hopefully they'll be able to finish it by May 13.
Each machine, testing them now.
Each machine. Okay. We cannot, some says that for the manual audit, the 1 or 2 votes that are different between PICUS and the manual audit, they say it's okay because it's just 1 or 2 votes.
Oh boy, no.
It can't be said like that, because that means a vote by me given to another candidate.
Okay. So you're replicate that many times over. And then you have, on to the curious case now of the machines at the mock election, some of them not transmitting. Mm-hmm. Is it coincidence? But we also had a report by our very own Cheche Lazaro telling us more about these signal jammers. An IT expert like you, do you think that figured somehow, and that can really derail the transmission of the results?
Signal jammers can be used to delay transmission. But the main problem would be, Comelec should have a map of all the polling centers and how signals are, like what telco is available on those areas. Mm. Not on election day, they'll have to change those SIM cards looking for a signal, like what they did on the UPIS. Mm. They changed from one telco to another, and then when nothing happened, they have to move the PICUS machine near the window so that they get a signal, and then after 1.5 hours, they're able to transmit to the municipal canvasser.
Was UPIS a polling precinct, also used as a polling precinct in 2010?
For Barangay UP Campus.
Okay.
Yes.
Right.
Because the voters there are actual voters for the mock.
Exactly. So the machines, when they were used in the May 2010 elections, were they able to transmit back then? Do you remember?
We were not able to. I'm not the one monitoring during that time. So. Yeah. I guess they were able to transmit.
So something happened between 2010 and 2013 that made them unable to transmit.
They were able to transmit, but it's a bit long.
Yeah.
Like for that mock poll, it's about 1.5 hours just to transmit to the municipal canvasser.
And what does that tell you? If the transmission takes that long a time,
many things can happen in an hour and a half.
Like what?
Like other PICUS machines sending different results to the, like a fake PICUS machine.
A fake PICUS machine?
Yeah, it can be done.
What is a fake PICUS
machine? Say you have another machine pretending to be the PICUS machine of the UPIS, and then sending
can
results.
They clone a PICUS machine?
It's possible.
It's possible.
It's possible.
I mean, how do you clone a PICUS machine?
That's just a computer.
Okay.
It's the same computer. So if there are other candidates that would try to mandaya, no? So that's one thing that they do, no? Clone a PICUS machine.
You're making me feel not so confident.
But hopefully nobody would do that. But in 1.5 hour. Wherein you are trying to transmit, that's already a bit of a long waiting time.
Uh-huh.
So what Comelec should do is that they should have a map already of what telco is have adequate signals there.
Yeah.
So say test it a day before, and then if they identify that this telco is have a great good signal there, then use it during the.
But they have backups, Rick. Hindi ba tama? Because they're actually trying to transmit. on the frequencies of the telcos, but they have backups, the BGAN, the broad global area network, and the VSAT, the very small aperture terminal. They're all supposed to be in use, right?
Yep. They have backups, but what we're saying is that instead of trying to having a trial and error during election day, they should be able to determine if they'll be actually using BGAN or VSAT or telco.
The telco.
Not to test it during May 13, trying to select which one will work.
Okay. In the next mock poll, what do you suppose should change? What should be done?
Everything that has been we observed during the previous mock poll, everything should be fixed for the next mock poll,
including the manual errors that you observed as well, because there were those who were tinkering with a computer before the election started.
Yeah, everything,
right?
The rules, the procedure, how do you allow the poll watchers to be on the precinct? Everything, they should be simulated, so that we know if the teachers, the BEI, and then the machines, the canvassing later on the municipal level, are all ready. No?
Here's the last question for you, Rick, before we say goodbye. Do you really believe that President Aquino won the 2010 elections with these Picos machines?
Seeing the margin of the
President?
The president, I think he won.
He won. So he won legitimately, the Picos machine defects notwithstanding.
I don't know if they've done something, but the results showed he won.
Okay, but you have a little a little smirk there, which says that you actually doubt whether or not the victory was...
Well, because the machines, the systems that we use is, in doubt. So any results on that one will not would really be a doubtful result.
Mm. And it's the basis, of course, of Senator Mar Rojas's, or then Senator Mar Rojas's, election complaint against the Vice President, Judge Omar Binay. All right, Rick Bahage from Pontodaya, thank you very much
for
joining us on Primetime.
Thank you.
Coming up, the MMDA plans a dry run ahead of the EDSA rehabilitation project.
Mock polls, dry runs. Also, when we come back, we'll bring you our primetime pick for tonight from Super Bowl 47. Stay tuned.